Using the unique function in Excel is probably one of the easiest ways to find unique values in your data. So it's currently only available to Office 365 users, but should also be available in newer versions of Excel in the future. The unique function in Excel works by returning a list of unique values from within the data you select. So this can be letters, numbers, and most other characters. What makes this function so powerful is that it was created in a way to give you options as to how you can get those unique values. Probably the most common way to use the unique function is to have it return a list where each item is listed once. So in this scenario, all items are listed down the same column, some of the items are repeated, and you want to generate a list where each item is listed only once. For this example, you could simply type equals unique, open parentheses, select the items that you want to see the unique values for, making sure to exclude any headers, and press enter. The way that the unique function looks at columns and rows always makes me have to stop and think for a moment. So the default is to look through your data when each item that you're looking through is in a row. So this actually would be like our example here, where the items are in column A, but the unique function is looking at rows 2, 3, 4, 5, and all the way down what we selected. So because this is the default, in our first example, we were able to just select our data and press enter. But if we want to be more specific, we can also type equals unique, select our data. And so for this function, the last two arguments, if your response is false, you can skip it, which is why we skipped it in the first example. But typing false here to return unique rows will give us the same result. Now, sometimes you may need to use the unique function along columns, or in this case where the list is in a row, but each item that we're going to apply the unique function to is in a different column, so column B, C, D, E, etc. So in this case, if we wanted to get the unique values across these attendee names, we would type equals unique, select the names. Again, don't forget to omit from your data any headers. And this time we want to type true because we're looking across the columns. And now we can close our parentheses. You can also use the unique function to generate a list that omits anything that is listed more than once in your selected data. So for example, in this list of first names, only Buddy, Emerson, and Jill appear once. All the other names are repeated. So you can use the unique function to return only Buddy, Emerson, and Jill. So to do this, type equals unique, select your data, and because our items are listed in the default layout, we can either type false for the second argument or type two commas and skip it altogether. And then the third argument, you can select any items that appear exactly once, which is what we want, or the default, which is return every distinct item. But because we only want items that appear exactly once, we'll type true. Close our parentheses, and now we have a list that just shows Buddy, Emerson, and Jill. You can also use the unique function to find unique values that span multiple adjacent rows or columns. So for example, say you want to see unique values for both the first name and the last name, not just the first name. So to do this, you would type unique and select the data below first name and last name, and press enter. So like other functions in Excel, the unique function can be combined or nested with other functions to generate more custom results. So for example, let's say that we want to alphabetize the results of the unique function. So we could combine the unique and sort functions to do this. So in this example, we would want to nest the unique function inside of the sort function to generate alphabetized results. For more tutorials like this, make sure to click on these links. Thanks.